Have you damaged the crown, sir?
Why are you asking?
Because I see the crown in your hand and you're...
Is this yours?
No, it's not mine.
What is your business with this?
My business with this is the words of my religion. This is my religious
book. Excuse me. This is not your book.
Excuse me. This is the Quran. And I follow the Quran and the Sunnah.
So make sure you treat that book.
Respect.
Treat it with respect.
Well, excuse me. This is my copy.
Excuse me.
This is my copy.
Okay.
What is your business?
This is not your possession. This is Allah's provision. And He gave this to you.
Say so.
Says Allah.
So explain.
Explain.
How do you know
this is from Allah?
Because Allah revealed it to the messenger.
Give evidence.
Give
evidence.
Don't you have the book in your hand? Isn't the evidence right there, sir?
Well, excuse me. All sorts of books in the world.
What's the evidence this is from Allah?
Allah gave the book to Jibreel. Jibreel gave the book to the messenger, Rasulullah
sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Don't give me claims.
It's in there.
Evidence.
Open up a page. It's in there.
Look, anyone can claim anything.
It's not claim, it's in there.
Can you open the book?
Even the book can claim something. The question is, what is the evidence?
People like this, Allah has put a seal in their hearts. Look at this guy.
If you have the book in your hand, we're telling you.
Exactly.
Did you go through British education system?
Open up the page, open up.
Did you go through British education system?
Were you even born in Britain to ask me that question?
Sorry, what's that?
Were you born in Britain?
I wasn't.
Okay, I was born in Britain.
Good.
But did you go through an education system here?
I did, yes.
So, during your education system,
When going through education, were you trained to ask critical questions, find out answers and so on? I'm asking a critical question. Any book can claim anything. How do you know the claim is true? Explain to me what evidence you have to claim that this is from Allah.
You bring the book and you put it with other books, okay, and you see which one makes more sense. This is logical, yeah? I can see because of your white hairs, you're a bit confused.
Sure.
So give me details.
The Bible.
What tells you that this is from Allah?
Okay, what tells me this is from Allah? Who revealed the book to the messenger?
This one?
Yeah, who revealed that book to the messenger?
What gives you the reason to think there existed a messenger?
There existed a messenger. Did Allah send a messenger or not?
I don't know. I'm asking
you. Okay, what does a messenger mean? Define a messenger.
There's no final messenger. Do you know about archaeology?
I said the name.
Do you know archaeology?
I don't know what archaeology is, mate. Can you explain it?
According to archaeology, Mecca did not even exist in the 7th century. It did not even exist.
You know Mecca was pagans used to worship Mecca.
Evidence.
Mecca was conquered.
Evidence.
It's in that book, mate.
Evidence.
It's in the Quran.
Quran can claim anything. What's the evidence?
Okay, so what's your claims? What's your evidence?
Plenty.
Okay, bring your point and I'll debunk your point.
So in other words, you can't give any evidence for the existence of Mecca. You can't give any evidence for the existence of Muhammad. You can't give any evidence for this book coming from Allah. Why do you believe in these things then?
This is Allah's
Why
words.
Do you believe?
This is Allah's words. This I'll, is Allah's
no,
words.
No, no, you could not
you
give.
Are a kafir.
Look, let's. Okay. Let's go through.
You are a disbeliever.
Let's go through this again.
Excuse me.
You could not give any evidence for the existence of Mecca. Point number one. You could not give any evidence for the existence of a messenger. Point number two.
Are you sure?
You could not.
Are you sure?
Of course you could not.
Okay. So, go to Saudi Arabia right now. You're telling me USC is grave? So
there was see whose grave?
Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
Let me hold your mic. Explain.
Explain.
Okay.
He was buried. He was buried in his mosque.
Today we go to Saudi Arabia together and describe the process.
If you go to his mosque, you'll be able to see his grave, yes or no?
Look, my dear friend, let's do this very simply. Yeah?
Let's say we are booking flight tickets,
we are flying together, we're going. From there, describe the process. Where do you go and how do you ascertain that a grave there is in relation to your messenger? How do you describe the process?
Do you know where he's buried?
Describe.
I don't think he even existed.
So I don't know. I don't know what your claim is.
That's your problem.
That's your problem.
Have you ever read the early archaeological evidence on Muhammad?
Apparently the sky works.
What does it say?
Do you know how many times the name Muhammad shows up in this book?
Okay,
not a lot of times.
How many?
You know this guy used to work in IT.
Not a lot of times.
When you don't know basic details, why are you trying to defend your Quran standing here?
Basic details.
So you want me to know everything?
I want you to know some basic things, not everything.
Okay. So I just told you he wasn't mentioned a lot of times in the Quran. So what's your point?
How do you know Muhammad of Islam even existed?
Brother, don't ask me silly questions.
I know you're frustrated, but do you have evidence or not?
Yourself.
It's in your right hand, mate.
It's where?
It's in your right hand.
Okay, sure. Use the Quran right now. Tell me what you understand of Muhammad from this book, please.
What have you done to that book?
Read. Stop threatening. Read the Quran. Read the Quran and tell me.
I've read it multiple times.
I challenge you. Tell me, you cannot even ascertain basic facts of Muhammad. I'll give you a simple example. Muhammad being from Mecca, does the Quran claim that? Does the Quran claim Muhammad is from Mecca?
Nah, it doesn't. I don't think so.
Does the Quran claim Muhammad is from Quraysh?
Yes, he is from Qom al-Quraysh. Yes, he is.
I'm not asking whether you like it or not.
Does the Quran claim so?
He is from the Quraysh, yes.
But does the Quran claim so?
I'm not too sure.
It's not clear. Doesn't. The Quran says it is.
I'm answering you. Doesn't. Let me ask you. Does the Quran? This is the problem, my dear friend. You are a very young man, and so are you. My points to you both young people are this. Please don't stand here and try and soldier on to defend a book about which you haven't done basic research.
What?
Okay, let me go through this now. So Muhammad from Mecca, Quran doesn't claim so. Muhammad from Quraysh, Quran doesn't claim so. Muhammad having problems with pagan Meccan idolaters, does the Quran claim that?
Yes.
Pagan Meccan. Do you know how many times the word Mecca shows up in the Quran?
Not a lot of times.
How many?
I'm not too sure.
You see, my dear friend, this is the... Now, at least you're being a lovely man. You're a very lovely young man. But can I please... And you too. You're a very lovely young man.
Do you love me?
I am a Christian.
Do you love me?
As a Christian, I'm supposed to love all human beings. As a Christian, I'm supposed to love...
Am I your neighbor?
You are my right now.
Okay,
right
I'm your neighbor.
Yeah,
I'm your neighbor.
Right now you are my neighbor. So, as a Christian,
neighbor, why do you curse Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam?
This has nothing to do with Muhammad. You are a young man. What's your name?
My name, Alan.
Alan.
A-L-A-N-D. Alan.
Alan. Yeah. What's your name?
Ibrahim. Alan and Ibrahim.
I see today as fellow human beings. You are real to me. You exist. I know. Muhammad, no evidence whatsoever.
And that is my point so far.
So you're telling me there's no evidence that Muhammad existed?
Muhammad of Islam.
There's no evidence.
The Quran is the existence of the Prophet.
It's in his right hand.
Second, we have coins of the Quran. We have rocks written by the
Quran. What's your evidence? Where do you get that evidence from? I just want to know.
The companion who has lived.
Now, my question to him.
Give me any evidence of Jesus.
Exactly.
Same criteria.
Exactly.
Come to that.
We have graves. Do you guys have graves?
You guys, he's still alive.
We got him. What's your answer now? He's just started laughing. What's your answer now? Excuse me.
No. Let him give you evidence of Jesus.
What's this?
A gift to you. This is a book that I have written.
To take something, you have to give him something. You don't have nothing to give him, then you can take it.
So, Ibrahim, you asked me, if we have evidence, this is a book that I have written.
On the
evidence in relation to Jesus Christ.
Okay, so is this a man-made book?
This is a book that I have written.
Is this man-made book?
Plenty of evidence.
Can you give one?
Plenty of evidence.
Give one.
Number one, the city called Mecca, archaeologically, according to all evidence, did not exist in the 7th century. Did not.
A liar. I will expose him now. Yeah. Wait a second.
If he is able to provide archaeological evidence for Mecca, let's wait.
Do I have archaeological evidence in Mecca?
Is he dumb?
Archaeological evidence for Mecca from 7th century. Let's find out what evidence he is going to provide.
Your heart is sealed, bro.
Yes.
Your heart is sealed.
No. He asked a question. Now his second question.
Yeah. Yeah.
He asked a question. I give him evidence of the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Now show me evidences of the Jesus.
Show me.
Just wait and see. He will not provide an evidence.
I will not run like a coward like you.
Seventh century Mecca.
Okay.
Let's wait and see.
Jesus, evidence of Jesus. He will answer mine, I will answer. I'm looking for it.
We're waiting.
Yeah, Jesus.
Go ahead, Jesus. Revelations 2:2-3. Why don't you change it? Inshallah, we're gonna take over the YouTube channel, inshallah.
What do you mean take over?
The Muslims have...
Are you planning always to take over, threaten, and these
here
things?
We're gonna take over YouTube Excuse channel, because we're gonna debunk all of you guys, and then what, you guys gonna have no more content to post?
Excuse me? But you could not answer basic questions. Why are you planning to take over?
Excuse me.
You could not answer basic questions. Why would you want to take over anything? Yeah, let's see.
Here is the evidence.
Yeah,
now
look,
He will give about Jesus, and they will talk about Mecca.
Mecca, 7th century, what's the evidence?
I have the evidence.
Give evidence? Reader.
No, I will read it, but he has
reading.
Jesus.
What's the evidence? What's the name of the archaeological artifact?
Okay,
let's go through the details. Archaeological artifact. Which archaeological artifact? Is he going to show any archaeological artifact?
You ask me for evidence of the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and they give to you at least 3-4. Now, what evidence do you have for the existence of Jesus?
Exactly, you don't.
To you, Ibrahim, because you're a sensible man. Jesus is a historical character recorded by all qualified historical resources of the first century. You have Tacitus, a Roman historian. Suetonius, a Roman historian.
How long was this after Jesus then?
No. Wait, are you literally...
But Ibrahim, we're doing one step at a time.
And now he's talking about historian.
I know.
A historian's work is part of archaeology. He doesn't even understand basic archaeology. So, Mecca, what's the evidence for Mecca?
No, you didn't give me an archaeological...
What's the evidence for Mecca, 7th century?
For Jesus, you didn't have me...
I don't think it's fair, you answer...
7th century, what's the evidence for Mecca?
Has he got any... Ask him.
Has he got any?
Don't try.
Just wait and see.
Show me.
Wait and see.
Can you, brother? Can you?
We'll give 2 minutes. Just wait and see.
Yeah.
But note carefully. He will not be showing any. Please.
Let me get the mic. Let me hold it.
No, I'm fine. Will why? Not show
okay,
any.
Okay,
please.
Okay.
Where is the evidence?
Why is it that you always get debunked by the scholars that come in?
You remember what he give to you? He give you historian.
Yeah, I know.
Now he's talking about the existence
of Mecca. Why changing? Why running?
Listen. Diodorus Siculus, a 4th century BC Greek historian, while discussing in Arabian writing, the people that inhabit this part called Bizuminian, and live up in wild beasts taken in hunting here is a sacred temple. High veneration among all the Arabian. The historical library evidence, the reference, historical library of Diodorus, the Sicilian, translated by G. Beat Iskedan.
Is he getting to the point sometime soon?
Certainly.
Is he getting to the point sometime soon?
George Zaidan, a Christian Arab as well.
Yeah. Okay. Oh, wow. Did he give evidence for Mecca so far? Mecca?
Yes,
any evidence?
I did. Yeah. All the Arab who live in there. Did you give any evidence about Arab who live where?
So don't bring your...
Look, this is the thing. When he gets exposed,
so no, no evidence whatsoever. No evidence whatsoever.
Did he let me finish?
Don't follow him.
Let me finish.
No evidence whatsoever.
Look. George Zeidan is a Christian Arab from Beirut. He was properly talking. Yeah, because they're calling me to record. He was properly talking about the Doros, and he was confirming that Mecca existed. You coward. Now, which evidence do you have that existence of Jesus? Which evidence do you have about the existence of Jesus?
So, no evidence for Mecca. As you saw.
He's a clown. He's a clown.
Yeah. Thank you.
Clown.
Thank you.
Clown.
Thank you.
So, Revelation 2:2 wants me.
So
I'm free from this conversation.
Ibrahim.
I'm free from this man.
Ibrahim.
Don't deceive him. Don't deceive him.
You're not deceiving. He's not deceiving anyone.
Wow. Take a copy.
Respectfully, I don't want to take it.
This is yours.
Take a copy. Look, it's a gift from me. Please take it.
No, respectfully, you're sorry.
Okay, that's
maybe next time.
This is a man-made book made by you.
All right.